about that time. I am Reverend Michelle, and I've come again to worship with you. And I hope everyone here is feeling the very beautiful day that God has made for us, specifically for us. Let us worship together.
Settled pastor of Falls Village Congregational Church of Connecticut, and is chaplain.
Let us pray. Dear Creator of heaven and earth, and us, our minds may get caught up on the things that pull us away instead of nearer to you. We need spiritual food as a basic need, but sometimes we forget. We need you in our lives to remind us that you are the bread of life. You help us to form healthy connections, the responsibility of family, friends, and co-workers can be daunting. In every moment you create, we need you, God. Help us to help others by waking in us a way to create a difference in this world. Holy Spirit, please grace us even more as we worship and praise God.
Good morning. If you're a visitor today, you'll want to know, you'll find your green hymnal next to you or in front of you in the pew. We're going to turn now to hymn number 245. Let us stand and sing as we gather at your table.
Open our eyes, Lord.
Also in the hymn in the pew in front of you, you'll find the pilgrim hymnal. It's either blue or red. And we're turning to hymn number 335. Not the red Bible. There are a lot of choices.
The red Bible kept coming
out. 335, what a friend we have with Jesus.
Our heart. If we just look with ourselves and look in the mirror and see that we can be more in your eyes. We can open up further to see our neighbor, and we can do so much for all who are on this planet this day. Do we have any prayers that we would like to add at this moment?
Shia is very sick right now. Needs our prayers.
I would like to pray for all servicemen serving abroad and women serving abroad, those who are injured, those who are able to come home, and everyone who helps to bring peace to this country, whether it is in the armed services or whether it is through other means of nonviolence. Let us also pray for all children who are here with us today, those who have no parents, those who are separated from their parents, and those who are struggling through so many challenges that we cannot even imagine. We also pray for people like Aretha Franklin, who brought us a lot of music and joy through that music. We pray for those people that are on your hearts, but have not been spoken through your mouths, but are still peacefully part of your lives. We know, dear Lord, that our prayers may seem singular and individual, but you care for each and every single one of us like the many strands that are separate in our heads. We know that we are one family under and within and through Jesus Christ. Thank you for allowing us to be here this day. Bless that we are able to breathe in and breathe out and remember Jesus Christ through the bread. Amen. Amen. Jesus has taught us. It sounds simple, doesn't it? Now, why are y'all looking so tortured? Do you know that some adults feel that it's actually torture to say those simple things? Please, excuse me, and thank you. Have you been walking down the street and someone just bangs into you? What were you taught at home to say?
elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites. As it is written, these people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines. You abandon the commandment of God that holds the human tradition." Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside the person that is going in. There's nothing outside the person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they defile the person." Here ends the gospel.
Please join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Creator, may these words that have been pondered about be acceptable to you and enter into our hearts. My husband and I have been married for 26 years, and every year around this time, I put on these little bells that have been given to me for my wedding day, and I wear them until they actually fall off, which is about a week, because this is not a very fancy latch or anything, and they're not very fancy beads, but it's a constant reminder that we made a vow, we made a commitment to each other. And so not only do I hear it at my husband, but people ask, what's that sound? I hear this weird sound. I usually wear long pants or a long dress. So it's a reminder to treasure each moment and to listen and to hear, and to slow down sometimes. So that's what you hear as I keep moving around. And I have to keep moving around. Because I've been given this life to live, not to sit down by the wayside. And then, sometimes when you get home, you have a treat waiting for you, because that treat is just that precious gift that you have for yourself. And sometimes it's as simple as your last chocolate chip cookie in a jar. That last morsel of that baked good that you're waiting for to get home. And you get that chocolate chip cookie on the plate, and you've poured out that cold milk into a glass. Get the plate, and the cookie slides off onto the kitchen floor. What do? You have been thinking about this treat the entire day, and your day hasn't gone so great, and you're just a little upset at this cookie on the floor. 1 second passes, and you're thinking to yourself, should I just pick up this cookie and throw it in the garbage? Or another second passes, Should I take the cookie, brush it off, and still feel a little guilty as I dunk it into the tall glass of milk? Because it's already been 2 seconds. 3 seconds pass. Should I just pick the cookie up and eat it without guilt and have that treat and really enjoy the treasure of what you expected to have before it fell on the floor and enjoy what God had given you? We have this 3 second rule here. However, do you really want to go through experiencing it? Do you really want to have what God gave you? Or make a choice? You have 3 seconds. What are you going to do? Now, we have been told from young that we have to keep clean. We can't just change who we are, but we have to go with the trends. We're given this duality, we're given choices. A long time ago, not that long ago, we were told that foods that were free from pesticides were the best foods for us, organically grown foods. However, there's different types of organically grown foods. And then we found out that organically grown foods sometimes don't have that label of being a GMO type food, where it's incorporated with other things. So we keep finding out with things that are clean, that are not defiled, through research, through science. Everything keeps changing, and we keep having to make choices. What is acceptable to eat? However, if we keep obsessing so much with what we eat and what we wear and where we exercise, are we obsessing too much on ourselves? Or are we even thinking of the other individual? Are we taking those seconds believe that the other individual in front of us is a treasure that we need to take that time and experience like a treat at the end of the day? We need to take that time. We need to experience what Jesus decided to experience in the Gospel of Mark, where Jesus sat down with all came and sat at the table, which we are about to experience. Everyone is welcome. And people have different ideas and choices of what they consider to be clean, what they consider to be, let's say, the clean that we can think of is organic. Let's put that as what we think of as clean. If you are sitting at a table and you've only eaten organic food, and that food changes because that person did not have the expense account to buy that organic food, but they want you to be at their table, are you going to say, well, I'm not going to eat those carrots, I'm not going to eat those string beans because they're not organic and they're not this? Or are you going to sit down with the family and experience fellowship and that conversation that might enlighten you and have the Holy Spirit flow through you in ways that you cannot imagine? You have those seconds and that choice to experience God in so many beautiful ways. But what did the Pharisees come to try and do? Which was part of Jesus' larger congregation. The Pharisees were part of his faith, where they were so strict on the rules and regulations on what went into the body, what happened to the food before it went into the body, how the body had to be prepared. And yet, they were saying, to him in so many words that don't eat with those people. Don't eat that food. It is better to starve. It is better to throw that cookie into the garbage than to experience the treasure and the treat that God has provided. And Jesus tells those Pharisees, those people, those doubters, that it is not what is so important that enters into your body, but what is the most important thing to do and to feel is what starts coming out of it. What words can hurt another human being? What vile things can you do that will harm another by isolating a person, by separating a person, by physically doing damage to a person, by bullying another, and then even taking it into further steps? Jesus had to turn some words for people to understand that they were turning the words that God had intended. Now, am I saying that we are not to wash our food? That we are not to wash our hands? That we're not able to keep the precious gift that God has given us of life? What Jesus is telling us is to treasure each moment and to understand that we are all God's creation, that we all have a purpose in this life, that we all have choices to make, and we all have seconds to make that choice to not harm another human being in the fashion that it will harm God's creation. You're not to obsess. We are a work in progress. You are a work in progress. This nation is a work in progress. This congregation is a work in progress. We are to come to the communion table, and it is gloriously prepared for us, no matter who we are or where we are on this journey. We are welcome at the table. We are to come with open hearts and with open minds. What we choose to be part of our lives, know that God has created us and we are all acceptable to God. So when that treat falls on the floor, make that choice. You have 3 seconds, 5 seconds in other parts of the world because their choices have been different. In the West, have chosen to decrease time, but we can switch time around and understand that all are God's created and that the treasure is in front of us, not only at the end of the day, but throughout the day. We are all precious in God's sight. Amen.
In your holy sanctuary,
Joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every nation who have looked to you in hope. You proclaim your great and glorious name, saying, Holy, 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 God of love and majesty, the whole universe speaks of your glory. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You remember on the night Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and after giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup, and after giving thanks, said, This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood poured out for the forgiveness of sins. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Consecrate me, Holy Spirit. Come, bless this bread and fruit of the vine. Bless us all in our eating and drinking at this table, that our eyes may be opened and we may recognize the risen Christ in our midst. us this holy meal where we have known the presence of Christ. Strengthen our faith, increase our love for one another, and let our lives bear witness to your glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Together we say, Amen. Let us sing a hymn that's in you. Let's be the tithe of life. Thank you.
Thank you.